So I'm going to show you how to use Magna AR very briefly. I've got an iPhone and an Android phone. And the first thing I do want to show you is that there's a little bit of a difference. When I look at the iPhone, you get a nice, clear, crisp picture in the background. When you use the Android, it's a little bit more blurry, and that doesn't mean there's anything wrong with it. It just has to do with the difference in the way the software works on Android and iOS phones. So if I'm going to click data, the first thing I need to do is to make sure that my background field is somewhere around 40, in the 40s or 50s. If it's not accurate, then what I need to do is to move it in lots of different directions until it's recalibrated. You can always check online to find out what your background field should look like. And to plot the field, you just click, 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 click. This is the background field right now, but what I want to do is actually show you how to collect the field around a globe. This globe has some magnets in it, so it's kind of like the Earth's magnetic field. And the first thing I do is I kind of move slowly so that the camera can see the environment and get a sense of where it is. And then I'm going to collect the data. First thing I want to show you, though, is that the sensor is not in the center of the camera. You can take a magnet and find out where it is. On this camera, it actually ends up being, or on this phone, it ends up being somewhere up here. So I'm going to use the top of my phone in order to probe the area. It's not important to me that the globe is actually in the camera. I just need to make sure that the phone gets a good sense of space around where it is so that it knows where it is. So here I am collecting data using the top of my phone to probe. And you'll notice I get a pretty nice image, and it's always a little bit offset just because of the camera and the magnetometer being slightly different, but that works out pretty well.